Good morning everyone. Now we will discuss about those methods of separation which are used by the farmers. Yes, these methods of separation are used by the farmers to separate the grain seeds from the stalks and to separate the chaff or the husk particles from the grain seeds. So first one is threshing. Yes, the first one is threshing. After maturing the crops are harvested from the field, and after harvesting, just their stalks are drying in the sun. Yes, when the crops mature, they are harvested, and these crops are harvested just near to the ground. Their stalks are harvested, just their stalks are cut just near to the ground. Now these stalks are kept under the sun. These are kept under the sun for the drying, so that they can dry well. Each stalk has a number of grain seeds attached to it. Yes, each stalk has a number of the grain seed attached to it, and the each grain seed is covered with a thin layer, and this thin layer is known as chaff. So each seed is covered with a thin layer, and there is a number of grain seeds attached with a stalk. Now the process of separating these grain seeds from the stalk is known as threshing. So what is the threshing? Threshing is a process to separate the grain seeds, just like your wheat, just like your paddy, or you can say rice, from the stalk. It is known as threshing. Threshing can be done by the hands, and how it can be done? The stalks are beaten on a stone. They are beaten on a stone, and when it will done, when we do like this, the seeds will separate it from the stalks. Threshing can be done with the help of the bullocks, as well as this can be done with the help of the machines. So threshing is a process to separate grain seeds from the stalk with the help of machines as well as hand, and this method is mainly used by farmers. Now our next process is winnowing. Yes, winnowing. Now after the process of threshing, we will get the grain seeds. Yes, we will get the grain seeds now, but these grain seeds are now with some lighter husk particles. So these are the grain seeds, and we have some lighter husk particles. Now we have to separate these lighter husk particles from the heavier seeds of grain. So for this we can use the process of winnowing. Yes, winnowing is a process to separate heavier particles from the lighter one. So seeds are the heavier one and the husk are the lighter one. So by using it we can easily do it. And winnowing is mainly done with the help of the wind or blowing air. Yes, with the help of the wind, and with the help of blowing air we can easily do it. So when the wind is blowing, the lighter husk particles will move away, will make a heap. They will you can say from the platform, and the heavier seed particles just collected near the platform. So with this method we can easily separate the lighter husk particles from the heavier seed particles, and these lighter husk particles, it can be used as a food or a fodder for the animals. We can be used as a fodder for the animals. So these are the two methods of separation mainly used by farmers. Now let us see the process of evaporation through an activity. Are you ready? For this activity you need a beaker half filled with water, and you need a tablespoon of sugar with a glass rod. So just take a beaker half filled with water and add a tablespoon of sugar into it. Now stir it well with the help of the glass rod. You will see the sugar will completely dissolve in water. It will disappear in water. Now we want to get back this sugar. So we can get our sugar back through the process of evaporation. Yes. So first of all we will take the beaker and heat it. Yes, when we heat it, then the water slowly convert into its vapor form. Yes, the water slowly convert into its vapor form, and what is left at the last, when all the water vaporize, then all the water evaporate, then there are white residue left at the bottom of the beaker. The white residue left at the bottom of the beaker, and if we will taste this residue, these are the sweet in taste. Means these are the residues of sugar. Okay, so through the process of evaporation, we can easily get back the solid particles dissolved in water. Through this process of evaporation, we obtain the salt from the sea water. Yes, through the process of evaporation, we can obtain salt from the sea water. Sea water contains a large amount of the salt mixed into it. So when the sea water is allowed to just stay into a shallow pit, then due to the heat of the sun, the water evaporates slowly. And when the water evaporates slowly, the salt left behind. And this salt we can use after the process of the purification. So through the process of evaporation, we can separate the solid impurities, and the salt from the sea water we get through the process of evaporation with the help of the solar energy. Now we will discuss about the process of condensation. Yes, now we will discuss about the process of condensation. The condensation is just reverse of the process of evaporation. Yes, it is a reverse process of evaporation. In this process, the water vapor converts into water droplets. Yes, the water vapor converts into water droplets due to cooling. So it is a reverse of the process of evaporation. So when the water vapor condenses into the form of water droplet, this process is known as condensation. And the process of condensation plays an important role in the formation of clouds. Yes, it plays an important role in the formation of clouds. Clouds are formed after the process of evaporation and condensation. So after the process of condensation, when the water droplets combine together, they forms the clouds. Okay, and sometimes when we have to separate the different components of a mixture, we have to use more than one method of separation. For example, if we want to separate the sugar mixed with water, then we can easily separate the sugar mixed with water through the process of evaporation. Okay, so when we do the process of evaporation, then we will get the sugar in the form of the residue when we heat the beaker. But how can we get the water back? We can get this water back through the process of condensation. So when we doing the process of evaporation, means when we heat the water and the water is converted into water vapor, then just take a plate with the pieces of ice on it. Naturally, when the water vapor rises up and when it comes into the cool surface of the plate, then they convert it into water droplets, and these water droplets we can collect into another beaker. So through the process of evaporation and condensation, we can get back the different components of a mixture, sugar and water.